the beginning of what? Wisdom. Amen. So, you know, we just want everybody to know we're going to be teaching this way, you know, for the next several weeks. Amen. Because I've never seen a family. I've never seen children. I've seen so much devastation in families since I've been pastor. So much devastation. So many families that were just wiped out and went through unnecessary problems and troubles and sadness, and kids ending up being just like today at the funeral. We had one young man that was attending the funeral, and he was in chains. And they had a correction officer accompanying him. He was related to the family. And he's just a young man. But a lot of times, children get off because many times parents fail to what? Take responsibility and really begin, they fail to live a life of integrity. So I just want everybody to start out on the right feet, because these are principles that enable God to what? Release the fullness of his blessings. It doesn't seem like it would be, because it seems like God always wants to take something from us. Amen. But see, everything is based on what? Giving. Blessed are the what? Merciful. For they shall what? If you want to get a lot, well, you're gonna have to what? You're gonna have to give it out. The more you give out, the Bible says, there's he that what? That scattereth, but yet he gets what? A whole lot more. I mean, just get richer and richer. Amen. Praise God. So I want to be in that number. Amen. I might run, but you know, as the scripture says, weeping may endure for a night. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. But what joy cometh in the morning. When you scatter, keep scattering, keep scattering. Amen. How many believe it's going to come in good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running? Amen. But I want to point out, in the case of Naaman, he was about something, because he had spent much of his earlier life developing disciplines and placing himself in a position where he could really be useful as a captain of the army. And he had developed great. Why God was able to work this great miracle through him, because he submitted to God, because he was the captain of the host of the king of Syria. This is 2 Kings 5:1. He was a great man with his master. That meant that what? Amen. He what? He obeyed his master. He was in subjection to his master's command. Whatever his master told him to do, he was what? He was submissive. How many remember Joseph and all of the great men of the Bible? They had these virtues going for them. And that's the reason why we read them in the Hall of, read about them in the Hall of Fame of Faith in Hebrews 11. Honorable, by him the Lord had given deliverance unto Syria. He also was a mighty man in valor. Amen. But he was a leper. So that's kind of a background of what this man was all about, because he had developed disciplines and had perfected a whole lot of virtues in his life that enabled God to do some mighty things through him. He was able to release Israel out of the hand of their oppressor. Through him, great deliverances were accomplished. See, God uses, you know, God just don't use any old hobo. He wants to, right? Amen. But the Bible says his eyes are running to and fro, and he's looking for what? The heart that's what? Right. The heart that's perfect. Okay, I'm going to show you one more, and then we're going to have to go. Time is about out. Over the book of Acts. Acts 10. I'm just going to stop at a few verses, but it's a great one. A real great storyline behind this, Acts 10. There was a certain man in Caesarea called Cornelius, a centurion of the band called the Italian Band, a devout man, one that feared God with all of his house, which gave much alms to the people and prayed to God always. He saw in a vision, evidently about the ninth hour of the day, an angel of God coming in to him and said unto him, Cornelius. And when he looked on him, he was afraid and said, What is it, Lord? And he said unto him, Thy prayers and thine alms are come up for a memorial before God. And now send men to Joppa and call for one Simon, whose surname is Peter. He lodges with one Simon, a tanner, whose house is by the seaside. He shall tell thee what thou oughtest to do. And when the angel which spake unto Cornelius was departed, he called two of his household servants and a devout soldier of them that waited on him continually. And when he had declared all these things unto him, he sent them to Joppa. Okay, now let's skip down at the verse 17. Now when Peter doubted in himself what this vision which he had seen should mean, behold, the men which were sent from Cornelius had made inquiry for Simon's house and stood before the gate and called and asked whether Simon, which was surnamed Peter, were lodged there. Okay, while Peter thought on these visions, the Spirit said unto him, Behold, three men seek thee. Arise therefore and get thee down and go with them, doubting nothing, for I have sent them. Okay, and let's skip down to verse 23. Then called he them in and lodged them, and on the morrow Peter went away with them, and certain brethren from Joppa accompanied him. And tomorrow and the morrow after they entered into Caesarea, Cornelius waited for them and had called together his kinsmen and near friends. And as Peter was coming in, Cornelius met him, fell down at his feet and worship him, and so forth. Okay. Verse 33, immediately therefore I sent to thee, this is Cornelius, giving Peter his story. Therefore I sent to thee, and thou hast well done, thou art come. Now therefore are we all present before God to hear all things that are commanded thee of God. All right, in other words, Cornelius had gathered all of his kinmen and his relatives together, and his friends together, to hear what Peter had to say. In other words, Peter was going to preach a message that would be the door into the kingdom for the Gentile nation. A very important assignment. All right, but look at the character of Cornelius. Look at the character of Cornelius. Okay, what scripture can we find that? Okay, a devout man, verse 2, one that what? Feared God with all of his house, which gave what? Much alms to the what? And pray to God what? Always. All right, there's another scripture that talks about the character of Cornelius. Said Cornelius the centurion, a just man, and one that feared God, and of what good report among all the nation of the Jews, was warned from God by an holy angel to send for thee in his house, and to hear words of thee. Okay, so you can see that the character of the person that God uses is very important. Amen. Amen. So it's very important for us not to ignore a whole lot of these things that God, amen, said that it was necessary, that are prerequisites for him releasing his blessing. We just can't overlook these things. I know that sometimes after we hear the word over and over and over, we just let water on a duck's back. But the Bible says that everyone that have ears, they what?
Hear.
Take heed what you what? Hear. Take heed how you hear. Is that right? Take heed what? What you hear. And take heed what? How you hear. Because with the measure that you what? Hear. That is going to be what? The measure that is going to be what? Meted out to you. So you better make sure that you're hearing not just with your natural ears, but hearing it with your what? Your spiritual ears. Amen. Y'all ain't mad at me yet?
No.
All right. Praise Brother William's done. And he said, don't throw nothing at me. Don't throw nothing at me here. Okay, but the thing is that the verse 33, immediately therefore I said to thee, and thou hast well done that thou art come. Now therefore are we all here present before God to hear all things that are commanded thee of God. So in other words, Cornelius brought all those people into a position where God's will for them could be what? Fulfilled. Placed themselves in a position where God's grace or God's mercy could what? Could reach them. We're all here. We don't know what the message is, but we are here. We don't know what you want to say to us, Lord, but what? We are here. We heard the angel. We saw the vision. Amen. Praise God. And you honored my prayers. And here we are for whatever you want to use us for. And they were used to open the door of salvation to the what? Gentile world. That's us. Everybody. I mean, that was a big thing. That was a huge assignment. But just look at the virtues of this man that God used to open the door. There was no riffraff. Somebody that obeyed God. One out of every 10 times God told him to do something. The Bible says he was a devout man, one that feared God always. Amen. So I believe that if we would place ourselves in a position for God's blessings to be poured out in abundance, I believe that we will have a dramatic, amen, experience, a dramatic turnaround in terms of the level of blessings that we desire to receive. Okay, now because they positioned themselves, then Peter started preaching 34 through 44. Peter preached his sermon, and the Bible says, while Peter was still preaching his sermon, while Peter yet spake, verse 44, these words, the Holy Ghost fell on all of them which heard the word, and they of the circumcision which believed were astonished, as many as came with Peter, because that on the Gentiles also was poured out the gift of the Holy Ghost. In other words, for they heard them speak with what? Tongues, and magnify God. All right, so before Peter could finish his message, amen, God, what? Was pouring those blessings out of us. Before he could get through, woo, glory. So if you place yourself in a position where God's grace can what? Reach you, amen. Eye hasn't seen, neither ear has what? Heard. Neither has it been revealed to the heart of men the things that God has prepared. Them that love him. And these things God will reveal to you through the Spirit. How many can say amen?
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. So my message is in 2012. Let's get in line. Amen. Let's dot every what? Dot every I and cross every T. Amen. Whatever God told us to do, amen. Whatever we know to do, amen. We want to what? Do that. Because we want to place ourselves in a position where God's what? Mercy. God's blessings can what? Come on us and overtake us. Amen. God wants to run us down with his blessings and overtake us. Amen. All right. Praise God. Let's all stand and let you have a little early. Amen. Since everybody didn't show up, we'll give you a little prayer. Praise God. time to let y'all go by some 7:15. But such a few people, I say it's no point to use God, laying them out. All right, well, praise God. How many encouraged? How many encouraged? How many willing to go all of the way? How many are willing to obey the voice of the Lord? Father, we thank you tonight. In Jesus' name, we give you praise and the glory. We thank you for the work that you have begun in us. We believe the work you have begun, you will continue. In Jesus' name. Everybody said, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Now, Saturday night, we will have our